By age two, Aiden, our youngest, was hurting himself because he couldn't communicate with us very well. Out of frustration, he hit his head on the wall, the floor, whatever was around. Neither my husband James nor I had any idea how to help him. The pediatrician referred us to a speech therapist who taught us basic sign language. This was our lifeline until Aiden had more control over his speech. An occupational therapist worked on his sensory issues. Every trip to the grocery store, every haircut, every time we dressed him, assaulted his senses. Aiden was on the autism spectrum. Autism required everything we had. At the lowest point, we both quit work to be home and tag team this powerful foe that had our sweet social butterfly. This boy who loves people, makes friends easily, and has more personality than anyone I've ever met. This boy was being paralyzed by social anxiety on top of everything else, yet his heart desired the social connections. It was the saddest thing, the most unfair, I remember thinking. We didn't have the resources to get things that could make his life easier. It was time for a change. I started online classes at the community college. This was my way of being able to stay home with Aiden, and also with Gracie, Matthew, and Austin, who still needed a mom that had something left to give them. This was my version of building a new legacy for them, choosing a different direction. Shortly after I enrolled in school, so did my husband. Now we were both online students. My oldest even gave college a try after he got his GED. This school year, everything changed. I entered my senior year. Matthew, who is 16, began the Running Start program at Clark College, where James is a student. And Aiden and Gracie both began K-12. If Matthew is careful about his planning and his grades, he could graduate with a high school diploma and an AA at the same time. Grace and Aiden are enjoying the educational flexibility of K-12 at online public school. I graduate this spring and must decide whether or not I feel crazy enough to do the low residency MFA in creative writing at Goddard afterward, or if I'll just play it safe. Somehow, I think I'll end up at Goddard, if they'll have me. My heart is for every person to know they are never alone. You are not alone. Whatever insanity or hardship you are facing, someone has been in that neighborhood before. Reach out and find others who will understand. Your story is important. You are important. Don't give up on yourself. Finish your schooling and be what you want to be. Do what you want to do. On the flip side, be kind to your fellow humans. We could all be a little nicer to those around us. We can't always know what someone is going through. Many of us are good at hiding the hurt. I challenge all of you to step out of your comfort zone. Find out more about the people around you. Ask questions. Get involved. Lend an ear. Just be kind. Be kind to yourself, too.